So now we'll work on a bit of using the dplyr functionality or dplyr package, which basically helps us to subset our data. The same functionality which we could have used using a subset function, or we could have directly accessed the object itself by using the box brackets and using some setting clauses. This makes it very easy to access it and then to use some piping symbols. So as you have already used this package, so just load this dplyr package. So within this you have the filter options and all those things. So let's import the data again. So let's see data Boston, and say we want to extract some data from this data set, data frame. Right? So we can check the class again. It's Boston, so it's a data frame, 106 observation, 14 variables. Let's start using the filter functionality. So it's a filter function. So your object is Boston, and you can say I want to select any object. So test. Say C1 to 4. Okay. Class collector. So you just extracted filtered on the rows, giving a condition that the METV value should be greater than 30. Say I want to repeat this, but then again I'm not interested in all of these columns, so I might say the piping symbol allocation sign. This is the chaining functionality. So I might say now the select on this case, wherein I might say that okay, I'm interested in say just the first columns. So obviously, as you said in the previous case, when you just ran the filter, it extracted all the observations. So you can see over here the dimensions of test. So let me check the dimensions of test. It's 84 rows and 14 columns. When I do the second part, that is the chaining, it goes on this data set which has all the observations where the value of METV is greater than 30, and there are all the columns in the data set. This statement specifically, wherein you are using this filtered data, passing it into the select clause, wherein it is extracting only the first four rows because I have given that as a condition. And then if you do the dimensionality, it reduces from 14 columns to 4. So in this case, as against the subset functionality which you have used, by using the filter and the select functionality in the dplyr package, you are first filtering the data on a row condition and then extracting all the specific columns which you require, which in this case you have specified as the first four columns. You can select any of the columns which you want. Now this can be exhaustively used to change the shape of your data, to make more sense, extract only that set of the data which you require for further processing. Say for example, if you're doing a subset of data from this very base Boston data set, wherein you run a linear regression model and you want to have one more set of data which is for testing sake, wherein you don't want the last column, right? So you might say that okay, give me the rows, you want all the data, or say only specifically you want the first 100 volts. Okay, to give a condition over here. So let me say I want to do the model building on all the data where MEDV is greater than 10 and not less than 10. And I want to select everything, but I don't want the MEDV value to be included over here. So I might just extract that data. So this would become my testing data set, because I might build my linear regression model on Boston, the overall data set, and I want to just test it against this X's which are supplied over here. So you can use it for any kind of subsetting, filtering on the existing data set. It does the same exact functionality like a subset function, but just gives you an edge in terms of selecting in chain based approach.